All right, so here is the review of this foot massager. Let me go around to the other side and show you guys all the good stuff. So let me zoom in a little bit. So this one has heat here, right there. It also has air pressure right here. Oops, I'm trying to do this from behind the camera, so I'm kind of goofy. And then we have the massager itself, which is right there. So we have heat, we have the massager, and then we have air over here, and then the intensity, so depending on how much you push this, so it's high, medium, or low, and the power on button, of course. So that being said, let me zoom out, come around to the other side, and I'll kind of share with everybody the my review of this product. So don't mind me, I'm in my Sunday PJs, my kick around the house gear. So the product itself is about 16 inches top or length, about 15 inches, 14 inches wide, weighs about 9 pounds. It has, like I said, air pressure, so the inside blows up, puts pressure around your feet. Then the intensity of the massagers themselves, and then which mode you want it on. So you can have both of them going on at the same time and all three with the heat, or you can have just one mode by itself, one mode by itself, or one mode in the heat, one mode in the heat. So that's kind of how it works. So the initial review of this product is, if you got fairly big feet. Now, it does say that, you know, it holds up to someone's feet that's, you know, size 12, 13 thereabouts. The challenge with that is, although your feet go in that far and it holds it, the massager doesn't span that far. So what I mean by that is, here in the back where your heel is, there's very little activity from the massager itself. So although it gets your balls of the feet and your the toes pretty good, it lacks the back part here where your heels are. The pressure on it is really good and it's intense. So my recommendation is, when you do the air intensity, start with low, medium, and then go to high. I did the high because I was, you know, a guy and I wanted to try the high intensity. And the first few times, it definitely puts a lot of pressure on the toes. So be cautious of that. So start to low, medium, and then if you want to, go to the high. But don't start at the high, because it will pinch those toes because they're not used to it. So just slide your feet on in there. Lots of room. All right. So let's get to it. So power on. So I have the air and the massager going, and then so it always starts off on low. So you press it once, it goes to medium. Press it one more time, now it's high. And same thing over here for the massager itself. Starts medium, or starts low, goes medium for one push, goes high for the second one. So both of these are on high right now, and it's definitely giving the feet a little bit of pressure there. But it feels really good. So like I said, the kind of the downfall is it doesn't necessarily cover the whole foot. So for somebody who has a, you know, size 12 or so, or even for the ladies, sorry, I forgot the ladies, anything over a size 8 for ladies, you're going to be lacking on the heel of the massage that this one's going to give you. So it also does the heat. So you turn on the heat. There's only one temperature for the heat. It's not three different levels. I turn on the heat quite often, but I'll be honest with you, I don't feel it that much. It does get a little warm, but it's not really hot to some degree. It's just kind of a lukewarm feeling. It takes a few minutes to warm up, so you're not going to feel it right away. But overall, it's not bad sitting here on the couch watching some Sunday football or so, or anything else. It does definitely feel comfortable. It's not overbearing, nothing like that. But it's a nice product. I think I got this one at Bed Bath & Beyond, I think it was. And this one was $149, so $150. And of course, you can get discounts on that, the discount they offer. So I'll post a link to the description for this product. Obviously, I use Amazon a lot too, so I'll put that up there for those that are Amazon buyers. There'll be a link out there for that. So overall, from a scale of 1 to 5, I give it a 3.5. From a rating standpoint, I think that's probably the average that you see on the ratings on the internet as well. So, like I said, you got a fairly decent sized foot. It's not really for you unless you're just looking for the focus on the balls of your feet and the around the toes. But that's it. So, like, subscribe, leave your comments if you like it. If you pick one up, let me know what you think. And yeah, so thanks for visiting the channel. Much appreciated, and take care.